me of Destiny, Ties of Destiny. Where you go around on the ship. Or a golem or something.
What's the weather called?
What is that?
That's called a pangyon, a type of bird native to this area.
Pangyon.
Their meat is succulent and tender, and makes a lovely stew.
Wow, what's it taste like?
You'd eat that poor thing? Savage.
Oh. You're one to talk, demon.
It was one of my mother's specialties.
All right, enough of the chit-chat. Mogilu, what's this grimoire friend of yours like?
Well, how do I put it? Oh. You know, like that.
Like what?
Well, to put it in a way those of meager imagination can understand, Grim's got a sort of listless, aristocratic air about her. A noblewoman in her twilight, you could say.
So you mean, like, a woman, but different from Velvet and Eleanor.
You're not wrong there. Tell you what, just keep an eye out for a grown woman.
Grown woman? Okay, I got it.
Well, since we got her name, we could start by asking around.
Exactly. Now you're talking. What's up, kiddo?
Mogilu, you're a grown woman yourself. So why is it you have trouble clearly expressing your real feelings?
Good question. Put simply, a long time ago, mine broke. Bagow! Chapoom! Bye-bye!
Your feelings broke?
Come on. Let's question the townsfolk.
Is that thing called Cold Four or something? What are you talking about?
The place we can't go, or you think we can't go?
Well, we probably headed there after this. But I wonder why we can't head back to the snow area place where we're not even going into the town.
So far, I don't like four of them. All those awards have been shit. They don't give no XP and they lose all stuff I already have. And this is some sort of a side quest, but I have to do them all. But I guess some fans where you get to get the boost items things the first time you do them. The stuff that ends in not. No idea if there is any reason to repeat them over than collecting equipment for dismantling.
So, a rage, I take it.
They're mainly used to grind grade.
Oh, to go there just to fight monsters?
Some reason you might repeat these. Grind gear for dismantling really helps you if you want to get the 99 limit. So you could get about 50 pieces of equipment to 10 for that. There are some enemies that are missable in the game, but can be fought in their lane. So you can get them from monster books or other unique equipment. The 10th one is great for farming gold. 100k per run. 200k with double grade, and you can shark bottle to further that even. It's an error that you can record, so it will, if you want to make combo videos or something, don't have a capture card, you can do them here. There are a bunch of tiles where the arena is the most efficient place to level them. Oh shit.
Whoa, you hear that song music, Kurta? Raises martial and hidden art damage. Look at this place.
Just level all your gear to plus 10 and reaching level 200 will make your make you very strong. Here's some items with good limit growing skill with juice casting time. So the weapons go to level 10. Oh, that's a nice looking place.
Yep. That's why I stopped. I was like, oh, she's too busy reading some shit. In my father's days, Sun God was a paradise where all you need to do was fish. But now we're crushed between demons on the one front and exorcist rules on the other. My generation missed out on a good life.
I think we gotta do those island things when it appear. Because I think some of them can miss, I think. A lot of grade and gold from those places.
Man, those probably better off camera then.
I think it's kind of like a burrito. Pardon me, we're looking for a woman named Rora. Do you know her? I'm afraid I don't. Oh, but I know where to get grim worms. They're lump things, a bit like love worms. You can use them as bait, but for my money, a cat worm is always the better option.
I see. Thank you for your advice.
Well, that was a whole lot of useless information.
That's what I would say. I'm like, we're looking for a woman. We're not looking for no damn fishies.
A bar!
I'm looking for a woman named Grimoire. Do you know her? Well, I've been here 29 years, and I still don't have a female acquaintance. Right. Sorry I brought it up.
Damn. Some folk up north criminalize the people of South Glen for eating Popton. I'm Southern Glen born raised, but I see where they're coming from. After all, up north they eat red peg. Now that's just downright cruel.
So then they should not be talking.
So how do you like our island? Nice and laid back, right?
It's quite a bit different from Logris.
This place was even more relaxed before the opening. But recently, a lot of our young folk have gone starry-eyed about the city and left us in the lurch.
It's still better than it was when the demons first started showing up. We have the Abbey to thank for that. And because people are traveling more now, the need for ships has skyrocketed. Our lumber industry is booming.
In other words, when the money started flowing, people let it go to their heads?
That and those exorcists and soldiers from the bigger cities, they really seemed sophisticated. People from the other islands wear different clothes and have things we don't, you know?
Getting worked up and worked over by what's trendy. Is that foolishness not the very definition of youth?
If this keeps up, our island's traditions will fade away. That's what worries me.
You feel,
I understand how you feel, but you have to give young people the freedom to be themselves.
Throw your bag.
Anything dealing with underwear, he won't go in.
Yep, that's mom's dude.
Shut up.
That's how I do it. Hello, soldiers. How you doing? Oh, look at that. That is so cute.
They're gonna have a big old stuffed doll of him.
They should have. Oh my god, we'll have a big, I love to have a little stuffed doll. Sticky paper. Are you done with that? Yeah, you done with that. There you go, your new one. Souls!
Look at this. Well, from what I'm reading from, it's a lot of those class four places. That's the first one to.
Then you just hear raging going on about.
Because he only did the first few. The first few were supposed to be for low levels or whatever. Oh.
Ooh, poison. Anybody in the main group? All right. She's doing her. You still doing yours. You're almost done. She's almost done. No yawning. No yawning. No yawning. No yawning. Oh yeah. That's the way I came.
Makes me wonder if her brother was gonna make. Gonna have that power.
Hello, sir. Do you know a woman? Oh. Wait, what's over there?
It's become common practice to use Southgan lumber for shipbuilding, but there's a reason. Our trees really are the best for it.
Natan trees only grow in Southgan. Their wood is light, tough, and doesn't rot. Perfect for shipbuilding.
You know your stuff. Long ago, before people knew how to build seafaring vessels, Midgan and Southgan were separate countries. Then our ancestors fashioned rafts out of Natan logs and floated all the way to Midgand. A Midgan craftsman, amazed to see a humble raft cross the open sea, return with our ancestors here to Southgand.
He had used the natant logs to build a large, sturdy ship.
Thanks to him, commerce took off between Midgand and Southgand, and the age of exploration began. The excitement of a new age had everyone floating on air, but within mere decades, Midgand declared war on Southgand.
Ironically enough, it was ships made from trees from their islands that enemies used to invade them.
The fighting continued for a long time, but in the end, Midgand emerged the victor. Our islands were occupied. As hard as things were, our ancestors still like to joke about it. They'd say, age of exploration, more like age of exploitation.
When things were that bad, they could still joke about it?
Southganders have always been a cheerful bunch. We tend to look for the silver lining in every cloud. It may not seem like it these days, but Southgan used to be a place where the laughter would never cease. Some people even used to call it Shenanigand.
Shenanigand. This must have been a really fun place.
But it was. Wanna see
the shepherd?
It's the shepherd!
Estrada! Wait, we haven't seen Estrada on every episode.
I think almost. It's always start with Estrada. I can't do it,
it's
man. No, I didn't do
it's
anything. I didn't do anything.
Hey, cat.
Okay, cat. You're taking everything now. Can we get under? No, we can't get under. It's blocked.
We found all the chests so far.
See, that seems hard to find people.
So do you want to go to that class? Four place, or are you just want to continue on?
We can do it after we meet this lady that we're looking for.
Oh, Chud.
Oh, no, Chud.
I had a twin brother that died when I was little. It's been 60 years since he passed away, since he's passed, but I will still pray that his soul rest in peace. You have my corner. What was the accident? No, it was the trail of your sickness. He heard the voice of the sea and the wind, but I never could. He was always such a pure boy.
Sounds like something Velvet's brother had. My grandfather told me there were once many Emporians. Oh, them. Huh? That's kind of confusing. Wait. What is Endomion associated with?
That's what I want to know.
We can't marry you off. You two are too stupid.
Please bless me with a large hall, safe village, a happy home, freedom from disease, financial stability.
Oh my god.
And whatever else comes to mind, thank you.
Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Repent? Are you talking to me?
Yes. When I look at your vestments around your chest, your hips, I can tell your sins are many and deep.
Say that again. Exactly what were you staring at?
Well, mankind is rife with sin, and I am no different. You must acknowledge your misdeeds and confess them to the great Imperians. By confronting your sinful urges, you will be empowered to resist them.
Is that so? You're saying I just need to confess all the bad things I've done?
Yes. Confess your darkest sins, my child, assured that none is beyond the forgiveness of the Imperians.
Imperians, hear my confession. When I was in prison, I instigated a riot and used it to break myself out.
Huh?
Then I set fire to some warehouses in town and stole a ship to make my getaway. Then I teamed up with some pirates to destroy a military fortress. I killed anyone who got in my way.
What?
What do you think, Father? Will the Imperians forgive me?
I think you should turn yourself into the Abbey and let them help you repent.
That's convenient. I'm already planning on going to the Abbey. You see, I'm going to kill their boss, Artorius.
I need an exorcist over here! Quick! Somebody! Anybody!
That's about how I figured it'd go.
Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Are you talking to me, perchance?
I am. You look so deeply sinful, I wouldn't even know where to begin. Now confess!
Oh, how long have I waited to bear my soul to someone? But I've always lacked the courage. Praise be to the Imperians who have bestowed upon me this chance today!
Ah, your devotion to the Imperians is most...
No! It is you who has captured my devotion, my darling! There's no one else I want but you!
What? Me? But my life is in service to the Imperians.
Hush! I want you to look at me the way I look at you. Hold me, darling! Smother me in your embrace!
I don't...
Those were the kind of lines I read in a romance novel. It wasn't even that exciting a book. I wasted so many hours with that piece of trash. Please, forgive me for not putting myself to better use.
Ah! Lying! To a priest! How could you?
Oh, no. I meant to confess my sins, but instead my confession was another sin! Forgive me, Father, I've transgressed once more.
I don't want to forgive you!
Oh!
Damn.
He was so excited and dang!
What, me?
Oh god, it must have been funny.
Show him how I...
He told the shit out of him.
Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Who? Me? I don't think I've done much that needs repenting.
No, my son. You must be mistaken. For I can tell just from how you dress that a great many sins weigh heavily upon your heart. But it's not too late for you yet. You must confess your sins and repent.
Yeah, I hear you, but I really can't think of anything.
Have you ever wielded violence?
No. All I wield are my swords.
Well, have you hurt anybody with your swords?
Yeah, but I haven't been able to land a killing blow yet. I've still got a long way to go. But the next time, I'll kill him.
No, you have it all wrong. You must repent for how you've used your swords.
Oh, I get it. I need to improve my cutting technique, right?
That's not what I meant either.
Ah, then what do you mean? It's a priest's job to guide the layman, right? You'll have to start speaking more clearly if you want anyone to trust your advice. Get your act together, man.
Yes, I'll reflect upon the error of my ways. Wait, what?
Damn.
Yeah, I get it. I like how it was just them. It was not everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
I hope this is just like the church from that one. Which one was it? You had to keep going to the church to do your sins or something. I think it was in Hearts. I think it was, but it was funny because the main character would talk about the main girl's legs. So, I like looking at her legs. Is something wrong with me? I'm like, no. Oh, it went the different way. Care all the crap out of that. They all of them in each and every one way troll the shit out of that priest. Well, I told the truth. So I read the book. Well, that's like you thought it was gonna be a chest around there.
Well, it says zero chests, and we got all of them.
Oh. Is there another way to get over there to that lady? Go to that star.
We gotta stick our forehead beneath the floor over there. Don't tell any grunts, alright? Alright, I'll keep the secret, your secret fort secret.
Your secret fort secret. You can actually tell. What are they doing?
I'm the boss.
Houses are still so they can stay above the water. At high tide, the town looks like one big raft. So that's the reason. At first, I couldn't tell if it was a clever engineer or just snooty craftsmanship. Well, yeah, they have to do that.
So we gotta find two chests in here. Run, kitty, run.
No treasure chests. Your way? Just wondering what the kids are doing down there.
We're looking for a lady called Grunson. Does that name ring any bells? Huh? I don't know her. And let's face it, your pickup lines need some work. You got to have work, work harder than that if you want to catch my attention. At least I found a woman with some taste.
Oh. We're used to living freely in Sargon, so the Abbey rules really can't chaff. What is that? But if you think about it another way, it's a good chance to mend bad habits. Right, like how we can't just dive into the sea naked. Now we have to warm up and put on swimsuits.
They actually saying y'all
with that. Still no leads on that grimoire lady.
Mogulu, when did you get that letter from her you mentioned?
Hard to say. It must have been last year? A decade ago?
Take this seriously or I'll feed you to the sharks.
Oh, what? I think I'd at least raid a kraken.
Keep this up and I swear I'll eat. It's them.
The final preparations are complete. Once you've assumed your new post, everyone will act on your command.
Thank you, sister. But to be honest, I worry that these shoes I'm filling might just be a bit too big for me.
You need not worry. You possess a special strength and quality that others lack. Shepherd Artorias has high hopes for your deployment to Palamedes. Fear not. Just be yourself and you'll do fine. Believe you're a leader, and you will be.
Yes. I'll try to make you proud, sister.
They're sending him to Palamedes? Is that the name of a facility on this island?
I had better get going.
Safe travels.
Oh, one more thing. Be careful around the demon in Haria. It's stronger than it looks. We've even had some casualties.
Understood.
Just love their outfits.
Also, if you must drink the water, remember to boil it.
Sister.
I know. I worry too much. But I just can't help myself.
So, there's a demon in Haria. Sounds like it's a pretty feisty one, too.
If so, it may prove useful.
Still, what magical timing for Oscar to show up here at the very same hour we do.
I understand your suspicion of me, but have you any proof?
None, it's true. But as an exorcist, you're certainly sympathetic to the Abbey's cause.
And soon you may wish we were sympathetic.
Eleanor hasn't been snitching on us. I'm sure of it.
And how would you know? Are you watching her even when she's taking a bath?
Huh? No, I don't. I always stay outside when she's taking a bath. And...
Then isn't it possible she's communicating with the Abbey in secret while you're not there?
You pledged to obey me until the day you die, correct?
Yes, that I did.
Remember, when you two trade blows, only the Abbey wins.
One less demon, and one less traitor for them to worry about.
While we're standing around here arguing, that demon could be attacking Grimoire!
It's true. Let's find some more people to question around town.
That bath scene was funny.
There she jumped.
So what's it really like?
Huh?
The connection between Malak and Vessel. Do you share, like, thoughts and feelings?
Sort of. When I'm dwelling inside Eleanor, I can see what she sees and hear what she hears. But I can't read her thoughts or her emotions. Sitting in a box doesn't teach you how the box feels.
I see. In that case, I want to give her as little time alone as possible.
I don't want to bathe with her, all right?
I know. You're a boy and all. For her baths, we can send Bienfu. No, that's a bad idea. It'll have to be Mogulu, or myself.
Phew.
What sort of boundaries have you and Eleanor drawn? How do you sleep?
We talk before bed sometimes. But it's not like I'm sleeping by her side or anything. It's easier for me to tell when she wakes up if I'm dwelling inside her.
Does she ever get out of bed at night?
Not in my experience. And she sleeps so peacefully.
Huh?
When she's around you guys, she always looks so stern. But when she's sleeping, her expression is... softer, you could say. She lets her hair down, too. And I think it's kind of prettier that way.
Huh. So that's what he likes. Well, keep an eye on her, but...
But?
Watch out for the older girls.
Huh? Teresa and Oscar sure seem close.
I've known them since I was an initiate, but I've never seen them quarrel, not even once.
Did you ever fight with your brother, Velvet?
Yeah, I guess I did. Sometimes I'd chew him out, and he'd sulk and stop talking to me, but I found that adorable too.
You did?
No matter how much he dug in his heels, or tried to talk like he was in charge, after a while he'd be right there trailing along behind me.
Like a little puppy dog.
Puppies are a lot more obedient. I always had to keep an eye on him. Little brothers are odd creatures.
Rokuro's a little brother. Is he adorable, too?
Huh? I don't think a little brother who's out to kill you is in any way adorable.
But Shigure seemed like he was having fun.
Sometimes you just don't make sense.
Huh? I don't know.
Little brothers.
Do you have any siblings?
I'm an only child.
Well then, that's perfect. You pretend the boy is your little brother.
Huh?
That's a bit extreme, but actually, when I'm talking with Lafayette, sometimes I think, this is what having a brother must feel like.
I could be Eleanor's brother.
Don't take any of this nonsense seriously, Lafayette. Malakim are just tools to exorcists. She can never think of you as her brother.
Oh, yeah.
You're wrong. I've changed how I view Malakim. I know that's true because I can think of him as a brother.
Right.
She's all talk. Don't believe her.
It seems to me like you're the one who's treating him as a tool, by forcing your own opinions upon him.
Ooh, two sisters struggling for the affections of their brother. Eeny teeny candlestick, which one will the Muppet pick? How about an older brother instead?
Yeah, that jealous mark really hit her. Oh, no, she doesn't. That's my little brother, bitch. Oh, that was so funny. It's all fun for Marilu.
The people of Southgand originally worshipped Aminuch, the Empyrean of Water. The lives of the people of the Southern Isles are inherently tied to the sea. Whether it was gratitude for a good catch or an appeal for protection, everyone offered their prayers to Aminuch.
But the Abbey worships Innominat, don't they? Do the people still keep their faith?
Most of the people obey the will of the Abbey. But one small village deep in Southgand is a special case. The village is called Haria, and even now they keep their faith in Aminuch. They've even quarreled with the Abbey. I'm grateful that they fight off the demons. I really am. But do they have to dictate which gods we worship to?
They think they do. It's their truth. Then again, they can't control what's in your heart, can they?
Nope. Let's pray for both then, but you know, yeah. See, this is why religion messes everything up. They want to force you to choose their god because, you know, that's their truth. And then you go on and say, no, I got another truth myself. And then y'all fighting and wars break out because y'all guys can't come to their agreement. How's that been going lately for everybody, Trudeau? Somebody who likes to destroy the Bible.
What does it mean to become an adult?
The eternal question of youth.
Have you ever heard of the ceremony of adulthood? It's a yearly tradition on this island.
If I remember right, it's totally wild. Everyone throws bananas and porringes at each other.
Traditionally, yes, but things have changed over the years. Bananas and porringes are a thing of the past. People are always reaching for bigger and better things, right? In this case, it's watermelons. Whole watermelons.
You're throwing watermelons? That's gotta hurt.
Trust me, I know. But watermelons are the least of our worries. Recently, people have started flinging coconuts.
Coconuts? Those things are as hard as rocks!
Trust me, I know. Like getting hit with a brick. Now, every year, there are some kids who never make it to adulthood.
You don't mean they...
Yeah, I've kept putting it off myself, but it looks like this year I've got no choice but to participate. That's crazy! It's far too dangerous. And more importantly, how does it make someone an adult?
There are ancient traditions that say overcoming danger marks a child's coming of age. Some people still cling to the old ways.
You've hit the nail on the head. There are lots of old folks that sit around complaining how weak us darn kids are. The hypocrites. Back then, they used bananas and watermelons. They even cracked the watermelons ahead of time.
I don't think cracking a coconut would help much either.
So that's why you're standing about looking blue.
I'm so ashamed of myself for being scared.
If you don't want to do the ceremony, why not just skip it?
I'd love to, but I don't really have a choice. I wouldn't be able to show my face around here if I chickened out.
Having the courage to say no to something you don't feel is right. Isn't that the true mark of an adult?
Wait. You're right! Now I can finally become an adult! Oh, yeah! Look how grown up I am!
And getting carried away with yourself and acting the fool is the true mark of immaturity.
Sorry. You're right.
Yes, it is. Back then, everybody's like, I can't wait to grow up. And then when they grow up, oh, man, I wish I was a kid again. Now, I agree with though. I'm like, oh man, it was better when I was a kid, but then you did just hate going to school over and over again.
Hate those people you gotta go to school with too. Especially riding the bus. You gotta scoot over, dumbasses.
Yeah, your butts are not that small, you know. Some of you got big, wild hips and y'all butts.
No, they don't want nobody to sit by them. I said, you know, everybody got to get on the seat. Y'all gonna be on this damn seat for when we get to school.
Yeah, I never got that. It's like they just didn't want people sitting right next to them. I was like, okay. But then you got these big, fat ones coming in there, think they can squeeze in between you. And I'm like, no, bitch. Don't be squeezing in between me. There are skinnier people down there. You can do that.
Yeah, she said go ahead and go to the tournament to win the money.
Hey, this doll? It looks like Bienfu.
Ah, a keen eye you have, young man. That is a doll of the Empyrean Ominoch.
That's Empyrean Ominoch?
Yep, no doubt about it. I've seen her with my own eyes. Real dignified, but not without a bit of a temper.
You saw her? Why was she angry?
Well, the Abbey's banned any possession of the Ominochian faith in Southgand, despite her popularity. Gotta assume that's what got her all bent out of shape. I tried talking to her, but no matter what I said, she was just like, oh.
Wait, that sounds like... And that low energy goddess you saw, the doll you've got here looks like her?
Yeah, more or less.
Ha! Fortune smiles upon thee, weary adventurers. That listless goddess is none other than Grim.
Grimoire isn't human?
When did I ever say she was? So, shopkeep, where'd you see her?
I think it was down by McClear Beach.
Pensively watching the tide come in? That's her, all right. Quickly, to the beach!
Oh no, don't tell she has a bull's big bosom.
Why didn't you mention Grimoire as a Malak before now?
You can't be too careful with that information. Spies, spies listening everywhere!
People at the tavern.
But not this many flying around now.
Too busy killing things.
Nice.
Whoa.
Nice.
Well, I'm not shocked about this. She's always burping.
You're welcome.
See? She's mean.
It's warm in here. I'll let the cold air come in.
That's wrong. The only reason why we shut the door because y'all TVs are so loud. Loud TV
hey,
people.
Because I had a crazy person in my room. Fucking loud.
I like how slowly she shuts the door, too. It makes lots of noise there. Let's get the one on top.
It's a way of life for us. Trita, you a stupid bit bit
bro. I really like how this place looks, too.
Yeah, I really like it. That's why I stopped and look.
It's a true shame that Lady Teresa will be leaving our island.
I'm a little relieved, to tell you the truth. She was a bit too strict for a free soul like me.
I guess not even the heat of Southgand could melt her icy cold personality.
But strict as she was also fair. She never asked anyone to do what she wouldn't do herself. Even when we were fighting with Haria Village over the temple, she kept her cool and listened to what they had to say. If it wasn't for her, we'd probably still be squabbling with Haria.
That's true. But did the Abbey really need to take over the temple for themselves?
She was really pretty, too. Sorry to whoever takes her place, but she's the only exorcist for me. Lady Teresa Linares, you were our protector. Yeah, we need the chilly charms of the Frozen Queen to cool down the heat in Southgand. Ah, the way those ice-cold eyes of hers looked down at me with disdain, like I was something filthy. Teresa forever!
Wow, there's one in every town.
Oh, yes, oh my goodness.
Look over, Teresa fan club, grab around, brace souls, let us... seek beauty in the women colder, deeper than the northern seas.
Of all else, I expect the exorcist to be strong. Faith and honor aren't as important. The newcomer, Lloyd Oxker, was badly hurt by demons. Can we really rely on him to defend us? I haven't seen much of him, but he seemed like a diligent, kind man to me. Those are both defined qualities for a person to have, but they won't help him against the demons. At least, yeah, he was polite to Velvet when, you know, first met her, wanted to know her name.
Southgan lumber exports have been on the rise, but so has the popularity of Southgan cuisine.
Like Pengyang?
Pengyangs are our flagship food, and our Pengyang farms are flourishing. But porringes, bananas, and our other fruits also sell well.
I've never had any porringes or bananas.
Porringes are sweet but tart and very juicy. They're the perfect refreshment on a hot day.
They're that fruit that glows in the dark, right? Also known as candle fruit?
That's the one. And now bananas. They're soft, sweet, and filling when eaten raw. But if you dry them out, they get crunchy, like peanuts. And they stay good for years. South Gand is pretty well off compared to other places. The fish are plentiful, and the trees are heavy with fruit. That's why I'm shipping the excess to other towns.
This guy here? He's a true sailor.
Yeah, good luck. I wish you the best.
Hey, thanks. I appreciate it.
So by the way, it's mission done.
Scout ship said.
Seems like she's not in this beach.
Where the star at?
Hmm?
Where the star at? Press R1.
Yeah, I was looking everywhere first.
What beach is it?
Well, let's get this powder stuff off us first. That was the church.
I don't see the end here.
It ends on other. Oops. Wait. Oh, ends it.
Turn this off real quick.